अन किताबी, there's a word in the Quran called अहले किताब. अहले किताब means people of the book. But in the Quranic context, it refers to Jews and Christians. In the broader sense, anyone who follows the revealed book is called अहले किताब. In that context, even Muslims are अहले किताब because they believe in the Quran. But in the Quranic context, it's specifically referring to Jews and Christians. So अहले किताब mentioned in the Quran refers to Jews and Christians only. But in the broader sense, anyone who believes in the revealed book is called अहले किताब. Or you call it a kitabi, that's your word, but अहले किताब is the word used in the Quran. So in that context, Muslims are also अहले किताब, but please note, not according to the Quran. When Quran refers to अहले किताब, it specifically refers to Jews and Christians only. It's in context. But generally, anyone who believes in the revealed book can come under the broad category of people of the book. But whether the book they follow is revealed or not, we only know by name only four: Torah, Zabur, Injil, and the Quran. All the other books may be, may not be, we don't know. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Ra'd, chapter number 13, verse number 38. Allah says, لِكُلِّ أَجْلٍ كِتَابٍ. In every age have we sent down a revelation. So there are several revelations sent on the face of the earth. But by name only four are mentioned in the Quran: the Torah, the Zabur, the Injil, and the Quran. Torah is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to Moses, peace be upon him. Zabur is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to David, peace be upon him. Injil is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. And Quran is the last and final revelation which was revealed to the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So by name we know only four, but there were several revelations. So all the other books that claim to be from God, I say maybe they were the word of God or maybe they were not. I can't say for sure they are. Even the present Bible today, we cannot say it is the Injil. It is a corrupted form of the Injil. So all the other religious books, if they claim it is the word of God, I can say maybe it is, maybe it is not. But even if it was the word of God, it was meant for those people and for that time. All the revelations that came before the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran, they were meant for a particular group of people, and the message which was revealed was meant to be followed till a particular time period, till the next revelation came. But Quran, because it's the last and final revelation, it was not sent only for a particular group of people or only for the Muslims or the Arabs. It was sent for the whole of humanity. And Allah gives this message in several places. In Surah Ibrahim chapter number 14 verse number 1, in Surah Ibrahim chapter number 14 verse number 52, in Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse 185, in Surah Az-Zumur chapter 39 verse number 41, that the Quran was revealed for the whole of humanity. And because it was the last and final revelation, it was meant for the whole of humanity and is meant to be followed till the last day of judgment. So even if other scriptures were the word of God, it was meant for those people in that time. Today, all the human beings, whether living in India, whether living in America, in Canada, in UK, in Singapore, in Malaysia, they should follow the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran, and last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Hope that answers the question. Yes, brother.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi.
My question is, as bird flu is round the corner, BMC has given guidelines to the doctors to discourage handshakes and poultry products. So you please kindly advise.
But they said the guidelines given by BMC, that doctors should advise the patient not to do handshaking and not eat poultry products. I haven't heard this news. I don't know whether the news is right or wrong, so I cannot comment on that. But as far as the information, yes, handshaking opposite sex, naam ehram, haram. So I'm with them. Opposite sex, naam ehram, handshaking, girls and boys, male and female, naam ehram, opposite sex, haram. Within the same sex, male and female, female, no problem. There are several hadith, shaking hands, fine. It is mustahab, no problem. Regarding eating poultry products, recently, there's a bird flu, which is there throughout the world. Initially, it started in 1997 in Hong Kong. Later on in the year 2002, 2003, 4, 5, it spread to Europe and other countries, Indonesia, etc. Later on, it was identified in India, in Maharashtra, in the state where we live. So because it was identified, the government is taking all precautions about this, and many newspapers have reported that in today's headline, Times of India also, that bird flu. And there are reports that maybe one person has died. And so far about 190 people in the world have died in this past few years, human beings have died. So this is a disease which originates mainly in the poultry, in the birds, etc. And it can go on to the human beings, and there are chances human being can die. There are symptoms like cold, like cough. There can be conjunctivitis also. But the report also says that eating poultry products doesn't cause you to get infected by the disease. And if you cook the hen or the chicken very well above 70 degrees, it's very safe. It will mainly come by contact. So handshaking with the chicken is a problem. Yeah, I don't know where you got this from. So handshake with the chicken may be a problem. So the doctor says that don't touch the chicken and it's going to pass. Because the main infection is direct contact. And if that human being who touches the chicken, so handshaking with the people who are selling poultry products also can be another extension to it, you know. Those people are dealing with poultry and selling of chicken and handshake with them, it can be a problem, it's fine. But otherwise, I don't know of any medical reason why handshaking among the human beings should be stopped. For what reason? Why? Unless the person who is shaking hands is not a hygienic person, is dirty, and that's a different thing. But I haven't read in any medical book why handshake should be prohibited. Poultry products because of certain diseases that have come. But this disease particularly, bird flu, the medical science says it doesn't spread by eating as long as you cook it very well. It mainly spreads by direct contact. So that answers the question. Any sisters have any questions?
Brother, can you explain more on shirk?
Sister has a question that can I explain more on shirk? Sister has given a talk on concept of God, major religions, where quite a major portion of my talk is dedicated to this. Shirk, sister, in Arabic means associating partners. It means sharik, becoming partners. In Islamic context, shirk means associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with Almighty God. Shirk, in Islamic terminology, means associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is shirk and is the biggest sin. And as far as Islam is concerned, other religions, they believe in monotheism, but Islam, besides monotheism, it believes in tawhid. Tawhid is Arabic word which comes from the root word wahda. It means to unite, it means unification. And there are three categories of tawhid. The first is tawhid al-rububiyah. The second is tawhid al-asma sifat, and third is tawhid al-ibadah. In the first, tawhid al-rububiyah, it means unification and agreeing that there is only one God, and He alone is the sustainer, the cherisher of the whole universe, of all humankind. And everyone is dependent on Him, and He is independent of anyone. This is first tawhid al-rububiyah, coming from the Arabic word Rabb, meaning Lord. The second is tawhid al-asma sifat. That means unification in maintaining the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, this is categorized into five types. Number one is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God, should only be called by those names which He has called Himself and no other names. Point number two, He should be described only in that way which He has described Himself in the Quran or the description given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Point number three, any qualities of Almighty God cannot be given to any of His creation. For example, Almighty God is eternal. You can't say, I know of a human being who is eternal. Almighty God has got no beginning. You can't say, I know of a man who has got no beginning. Point number four is the name that is given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It only belongs to Him and no one else. You cannot give that name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to anyone else. For example, Rahman. You can call Abdul Rahman, Khalik, or Allah. So you cannot give that name, Rahman, to any human being or Allah to anyone. You can call Abdullah, the servant of Allah. So when you want to give a name to human being, give something else. If you want to use the name of Allah, you can say servant of Allah, Abdullah, Abdul Rahman, Abdul Karim. And the last is that those things which are unique to the human being, His creation, cannot be given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, human beings can make mistake. You can't say God made a mistake, Allah made a mistake. So you can't attribute the qualities of His creation to Almighty God. So these five categories come under tawhid al-asma sifat. If you break any one of these categories, it is going against the concept of tawhid. And the third is tawhid al-ibadah. That means worshipping only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and no one else. Only believing in one God is not sufficient. In monotheism, you only believe in one God. But in these three categories of tawhid, besides believing in one God, if you associate partners with Him, even that's called as shirk. And there are various examples in the Quran. For example, it says that when you ask these pagans that who is the creator, they will say Allah. Who is the person who has power in the heavens and the earth? They say Allah. Who is it that gave you life and death? They say Allah. The pagans, not the mushriks. But then Allah says, then why do you associate partners with Him? That means when you say all power is Allah, Allah is the power in heaven, in the earth. He has power over life and death, power over hearing everything. Then why do you associate partners with him? So only believing in one God and giving him good attributes, Tawhid al-Rububiyyah, is not sufficient. Giving him good names, Tawhid al-Asma wa-Sifat, is not sufficient. All three should follow. If you worship somebody else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you break any one of the three categories of Tawhid, it is called a shirk. Whether the first category you break, second or third. So here Allah says in the Quran and gives example that the mushriks believed in one God. They gave him good names, Allah. But they worship somebody else also. So shirk means breaking any one of the three categories of Tawhid is also called as shirk. And it is the biggest sin in Islam. Hope this answers in peace, sister. Ma'akhir da'wan, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen.
فيا رب إنك أنت السلام منك السلام إليك السلام فيا رب إنك أنت السلام منك السلام إليك السلام لأمر